one step at a time. Start to take a look at your life and ask yourself, what do I really feel about the women I'm approaching? Look around and say, what do I really feel? What's the most honest thing I can say to her? No, you don't want to walk up and say, you know, I want to fuck you up the ass right away. Maybe not start with that, but you can start with something simple. Like, it's really raw and nervous to say you have beautiful eyes, or there's something about you, I don't know what it is, the way you carry yourself. Or, you know what, I'm nervous walking over here, but you know what, goddammit, I have to come talk to you. And the key is, you feel the nervousness, you feel the fear, and you own it at the same time. You don't shrink, you own it. So in this video, I want to talk about what goes wrong when you try to copy a natural, why it doesn't seem to actually work. So many guys today try to copy what naturals are doing. They say, I'm going to reverse engineer what he's doing and do the exact same thing. You might repeat the same words, you might stand like the natural, you might walk like the natural, you might talk like the natural, but for some reason for you, it doesn't work. It's something we used to refer to as a social robot, somebody who is acting like somebody else, but isn't really feeling like somebody else. You ever notice that a robot doesn't have any feelings, doesn't have any emotions? It doesn't have any sense of expression because it's lacking the feelings and emotions. You can't really have a deep conversation with a robot. You can fake it, but it never really feels like the same thing. Well, it's the same thing with these guys. When they go out to a bar, they go out on a date, they're pretending to be the confident guy. They're acting like the confident guy. They're moving like the confident guy, but underneath, they still feel the insecurity. They're constantly worrying, does she like me? What do I have to do? How do I have to be? And on the outside, they're pulled out of their body and they're up in there and they're acting and standing like a confident guy. And it's just off because so much of the subcommunication is screwed up by the way they feel. You see, your subcommunication, the most powerful part or the most powerful communicator in your body is controlled by the way you feel, no matter how much you try to hide it. You have all these little 1% tells and giveaways that causes the other person to feel a certain way. Have you ever been in a bar and your friend just tells you, just be confident? Matter of fact, go up to her and just be confident. It's all you need to do. Girls like confidence. So you're like, okay, I'll just go be confident. And you go, take a deep breath, walk over there, and you start talking to the girl. But does it work? You walk right up, you're like, hi, what's your name? And what's happening there is that act of putting up that wall to cover up your insecurity so you can just be confident is actually the definition of insecurity. You're putting a big wall in front of you and how you really feel. And you're pushing the other person back with your intensity. Hey, how you doing? Because you're trying to be confident. You're trying to fake it. You see, truly confident people don't need to put up a big wall. They don't do that because that just messes with the depth of feeling in the communication. You see, the depth of feeling comes through what you're feeling from your heart, from your stomach. And they're not afraid of what they're feeling. Insecure people are afraid of what they're feeling. They're afraid of what their body's feeling. So they have to wall it off to act confident. If you truly develop real confidence, you're gonna start to learn to open your heart and let people see what you're feeling inside. You're gonna learn to feel your turn on and let a woman see you be turned on even before she's turned on for you because you're okay with it. You're okay whether she rejects you or not. You don't need to put a wall up to feel safe. And this is what makes confident people so attractive. They can not only handle the shit when the shit hits the fan, they can stay emotionally available while they do it. There's something here we call emotional embodiment that we teach as part of our workshops. And emotional embodiment or energetic embodiment is so powerful when it comes to being attractive with beautiful women. This idea of walking up with this intense energy, this wall that I talked about that is a fake confidence saying, hi, my name's Brian, what's yours, where are you from? Well, that's one way to do it. But what if you just changed it, a subtle change, and you dropped all the wall and you relaxed right down the front of your body, which is right through here, and you feel your back and you relax and you feel everything, you stop thinking so much and you looked at her and with that open heart, feeling low in your body, you just said hi and you relaxed inside while looking at this woman that maybe scares you. It's so beautiful, she makes you nervous, so attractive. What if you told her straight out, there's something about you that's interesting, or you're fucking beautiful, or your ass looks amazing in those heels and I want to thank you for wearing them. It could be that bold. The more you own the compliment, the more powerful it is. The more you show you're not afraid of her or her response. But you got to mean it. You got to be sincere. You got to be very genuine about what you're saying. You got to learn to be honest with your own feelings. And for a lot of men, that's the hardest thing. They've never been honest with themselves, so how are they supposed to be honest with somebody else? So I want to invite you into this idea that you can start developing this honesty one step at a time. Start to take a look at your life and ask yourself, what do I really feel about the women I'm approaching? Look around and say, what do I really feel? What's the most honest thing I can say to her? No, you don't want to walk up and say, you know, I want to fuck you up the ass right away. Maybe not start with that, but you can start with something simple. Like, it's really raw and nervous to say you have beautiful eyes, or there's something about you, I don't know what it is, the way you carry yourself. Or, you know what, I'm nervous walking over here, but you know what, goddammit, I have to come talk to you. And the key is, you feel the nervousness, you feel the fear, and you own it at the same time. You don't shrink. You own it. And I want to invite each one of you to try that. Try that on a woman this week. Walk up and be as honest as humanly possible while still being respectful, real, and let's see what happens. You're pretty is not typically honest unless there's a deep sincerity wrapped up in it, unless you truly, truly feel that. Most guys, they go up, and I'm going to show you the difference. Most guys go up and say, you're pretty, and they're talking from their head. Versus dropping down in your body and saying, you know, you're really pretty. There's something about you. I had to come meet you where you're talking more from down here. So I want to invite you into a practice, something to exercise this area of your life. Now, for me, it took me a little while. I was really bad at feeling and I couldn't feel my emotions. So I had to do a lot of moving meditations. But a good way to get this started is journaling. I love journals for people that are exploring their emotions for the first time. And what I want you to do is go out and find an area, maybe it's a coffee shop, maybe it's the mall, maybe it's a bar even, where there's a lot of attractive women. And I want you to start to journal what you really feel. Start to notice, do an exploration. Like, she's pretty, and then say, well, what's one level below that? What's more real than that? Well, she's kind of sexy. Well, I kind of like the way she moves. I like her attitude. Well, she's kind of cocky and that kind of turns me on. She's ballsy. And I want you to start to find more and more of what you really feel. Learn to speak from your emotions. And as a matter of fact, I don't want you to just do it with beautiful women. I want you to start practicing this with everybody. You're gonna find whether you're just saying hi to friends, whether you're talking to this beautiful woman or you're doing it in sales, as you get more real, people are gonna respond to you better. As you get more honest. See, honesty is an aphrodisiac. Now, this is a very complex process and it's not. In the beginning, you're going to walk up to people and say, you know what, I really love, and let's say at the deepest level, you love the way she carries herself. I love the way you carry yourself. I had to say hi to you. And you're going to find that lands if you really nail it. If you're a little high up and you're lying to her and yourself, it's not going to land. So the better you get at this, the better it's going to work. Like I said earlier, I don't want you to just apply it with women. Apply it with your friends. Start getting really real with them. Apply it with if you're in sales, apply it with your customers. And don't just use compliments. The next part of the assignment is I want you to explore things that maybe annoy you about other people. Like, for example, you know, that sweater, it reminds me of my grandmother's sweater. You could actually say that to a person. You know what, that sweater is interesting. It reminds me of my grandmother. Say something real to people. You know what, bro? I think you have fantastic taste in clothing, but this jacket you just bought, I don't love it. Learn to be real. And I want you to sit and explore the things you don't like. Now, I don't want you to go nuts telling people about the things they don't like, but I don't want you to be afraid to do it either. So once you've got the two lists and you've spent a week kind of exploring what you're really feeling, going deeper and deeper, avoiding being absolutely rude on the negative side, just real. You know, not like, fuck you, that jacket's ugly, but more like, you know what, I don't love that jacket, or that jacket's a little crazy, I'm not sure yet. But once you've got the two lists, I want you to practice just slipping that into your conversation in some places. Real compliments, real acknowledgments, and real truths about what you're feeling. For you nice guys, this is gonna trigger you. You're gonna be afraid to tell your friends what you really feel. You're gonna be afraid to tell girls what you really feel. And what you're gonna find is the more you get real, the more you're not afraid to tell people and you stop just complimenting them to try to get something, the more people are gonna like you. So this is a powerful exercise, but it's one that will help you break the nice guy. So again, you've got your list of acknowledgments. Get it, spend a week kind of writing them down, seeing what's more real. Explore your body. Do I actually feel that? Don't just say it right away. Do I actually feel that? Find stuff you really feel. Then explore also the pushes, the things that you don't agree with, the things you don't like, and get real. What do you really feel? Am I just saying it to be an asshole, or do I really feel that? Am I just saying it to get a reaction, or do I really feel that? And as you get more and more comfortable being real with people, what you like and don't like, I want you to start slipping it into conversation and just start to notice how people feel. Avoid being an asshole just for being an asshole on the push side. Share your real, honest opinions. And as you get more real, you're gonna find more and more people like you. Now, that's a simple exercise. If you wanna learn more and learn to actually get your high level of embodiment where you can actually get in touch with what you're feeling, or you're not sure what you're feeling because you're so disembodied, then you might wanna check out one of our events like the Fearless Man Live or the Fearless Experience. Because in those events, we really give you direct instruction on how to learn to feel what you're feeling more. But this is a great way to start. I always encourage exploration and play in this area, taking it light, being light, learning to feel your body more, okay? Remember, this is an exploration in what you're feeling, learning to be genuine, not learning to just be an asshole for asshole's sake. So if you find yourself just being an asshole, then you can learn something from that too. You're probably storing up a bunch of anger. As you get more real, you will find that people really wanna hang out with you more, spend time with you more, know you better. So I encourage you to get started on this right away. Spend as long as you need doing a little bit of journaling first, getting in touch with your emotions. And then as you start to get in touch with your emotions, slowly start sharing more and more what your real feelings are and get as raw and real as humanly possible. And again, if you wanna learn more about this, make sure to come out to a Fearless Man Live or a Fearless Experience where we can give you direct feedback on how to get in touch with what you're feeling, what your body's feeling, how to bring that out of yourself, okay? So with that said, remember to comment below. We wanna hear what you're feeling and what your experiences are and what happened when you applied this. As you're journaling more and more, are you starting to realize more about what you really feel in life? When you walk up and talk to people and start sharing more of what you're feeling, what is their reaction? What kind of reactions are you getting? Definitely let us know in the comments. And remember to like if you like the video. Remember to subscribe, hit that notification button. And with that said, as always, remember, only the confident really live. I'll see you in the next video. Take care.